Well, ladies and gentlemen, you get to see me for once on camera. For it is me, Jon-Luc. You may know me best from CJ Studios, but today, for once, welcome, as you all know well, to Hot Ones, where there are the hottest of wings. There can even be hotter questions. Will the mighty director of CJ Studios himself be able to take on the wings of death made by First We Feast? We shall find out. Happening today. Well, tonight. Behold, Cesar Rosas Jr. himself.
What's going on, you guys? So, it turns out that... Oh, by the way, shout out to John, because this is his birthday party. So, they're doing the Hot Ones Challenge, and I have become a contestant.
Welcome to the big leagues.
All right, we can grab the food real quick.
By the way, my family and my friends.
Okay. Hello.
Here's Justice. You know him well as the clown of the group. Psych.
I'm the clown of the group. What do you mean?
I'm the clown of the group, bozos.
So this one is the classic hot sauce. This is 1800 on the Scoville scale.
They're all in here, right?
Yes, they're all in there.
Okay, let's get this shot. I'm already nervous. I've never done the Hot Ones Challenge before.
Well, welcome to the big leagues.
Mm-hmm. I want to join.
It's like a little spicy. Are you joining too?
Yeah.
Oh, come right over here.
Okay, well then you guys are in for a treat. Okay,
so it tastes the... It doesn't really taste that spicy, honestly.
Oh, it's gonna... Oh, don't get your hopes up. So...
Oh, I've watched Hot Ones myself. I'm kind of I'm nervous.
You know what? That's actually a good transition to the question. What is the first episode of Hot Ones you've ever seen, and what is your favorite episode of Hot Ones that you've ever seen?
I've seen a couple. I saw one with Kevin Hart and Gordon Ramsay. I didn't really watch much of them, but if I had to pick a favorite one, it was definitely the Gordon Ramsay one. You know that dude can't handle spice.
Yeah. So this next one is Dawson's Cedar Smoked Garlic Sauce.
Ooh, garlic. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm a little hyped now. I love garlic.
I'm going to tell you, once you enter this right from number 2 to all the way to number 6, it's delicious. Number 7 is okay.
Yeah, it really hurts though.
I can taste the garlic.
I was...
Do you think it's dangerous that I'm doing this without water?
I just realized that.
You're trying to kill me!
Nah.
It's just a lesson to learn.
Okay, Cesar.
For number 7. Okay. I know there's some right there.
The garlic adds a really good taste. I'll admit to that.
Okay.
I can feel the spice kicking up though.
Mm-hmm.
So... My second question, if you had to do a collab with any music artist or any celebrity at all, who would it be and why?
Any celebrity? The YouTube stars count or just celebrities?
YouTube stars do count, but who would it be and why?
Mm. If I had to pick, if I had to pick a YouTube star in this case, I would have to pick Darman. Either Darman or SML. They're both inspirations of mine.
Nice. If you had to though pick one celebrity to be over here just to be punished for who they are, who would it be?
To be punished for who they are?
Yes. Like, which celebrity do you hate the most to where you would do this to them?
Who do I hate the most? That's a tough one, honestly. I would have to say that vegan teacher. Maybe she's not a celebrity. She's not a celebrity, but she's well known on YouTube, so. But if I did have to pick a celebrity though, it would have to be Will Smith.
Oh wow.
Don't get me wrong, I love his show, but I'm sorry, but I have to pick him. The
last time
was hella funny.
Which isn't Chris Rock. This next one is Calibra. Calabria.
Ooh, Calibra.
I said it wrong. It's a spicy version of a tomato sauce for spaghetti.
By the way, people, I've already done this, and I made it all the way to 10, but this guy right here, brother, tell him what happened.
I tapped out number 7. Number 7 hit my... How many rights to this kid show?
Not really. This isn't CJ Studios. This is my second channel.
Do they make these hot sauce themselves, or are they...
Yeah, well, they have a guy is called Heatnists. They're in Brooklyn, New York. And they have them transfer all the way here to California.
It's like second time actually doing
things.
Here we go. I
think
I got some
from
that corner. Right.
Thoughts?
Oh no, it's that type of hot sauce that kicks in like 3 seconds.
Yeah,
later.
Some of these sauces hit instantly, some of them just are giving you a head start.
It's pretty good.
You like it? You know what, since I mentioned tomato sauce, that's a perfect transition to my next question. If you had to choose between rather having only Mexican food versus Asian food, what would it be and why?
That's tough. Because, I mean, that's tough. But if I had to pick, though, I'd probably have to say Mexican food. Maybe because I am half Mexican. But at the same time, though, I really love Asian food, too. But I'm probably going to have to go with Mexican food.
Okay. What's your favorite Mexican food, then?
Carne asada.
Ooh, that's a nice
choice.
That's
my favorite.
And what's your favorite Asian food?
My favorite Asian food? Ooh. Sushi, definitely.
Are you?
I love seafood. I'll always go for sushi.
Okay. Are you ready to move on?
No, I'm kidding. Yeah.
All right. Next one is Angry Goat Peppers, the Phoenix.
Ah, it's yellow. You know that means it's spicy.
It's a mustard-based cantaloupe sauce.
Oh, that's
actually
why. Mustard cantaloupe.
Yeah, it's a very odd combination, but somehow it works. Just letting you know.
That doesn't sound spicy at all.
Oh,
this one looks
about to prove me wrong, though.
Yeah. Looks.
I thought you stole my milk for a second.
Have you not heard the term "looks can be deceiving"?
I have, and I can feel it already. Oh, actually, it tastes pretty good. Oh. If I drink the milk, do I lose?
You wouldn't earn a prize. I'll tell you that. You can keep going. Technically, since the prize has already been used already, I think it's safe to say it doesn't matter.
Right, just one tiny.
Don't do
just
it.
Just one tiny sip.
Don't do it.
One
don't
sip. If you take a yeah, don't be a wuss.
I
was being sarcastic. Don't be a wuss. So we both know that you're also known for your Beyond series, which has also became a popular skyrocket. If I had to ask you this, if you had, out of anyone, to axe off any main character just to even make you more of an important character in the show, who would it be and why?
If I had to kill a character?
Not just any character. Who would you transport from Beyond into this world, and out of us, of the regular cast, who would you put in there just to be axed off from the episode?
So I bring someone from the real world to the Beyond world and they die?
Yes.
Oh, that's tough.
I told you these questions are gonna get tougher as the wings get hotter. If you can't decide, you can just take another bite of the wine.
I'd probably have to pick you right now for the suffering of this challenge.
I can take the dub.
Guys, Jon-Luc's gonna die in Beyond City.
I want to be in that show more than anything.
The next sauce is Los Calientes Rojo. It is a well-loved favorite of this household, and I think you'll love it too. Made by the actual guys who made Hot Ones. No, not all of them. Fifth one, the first one, and I believe the last one were made by the actual guys. The rest...
My tongue's burning, so I'm going to try the back of my tongue this time.
Okay.
I'm scared.
This one's actually the most delicious one.
It's sweet.
How are you doing back there, Ethan?
No moral. Don't ever put hot sauce to the back of your tongue. It will hit your throat bad. Yeah. And if you zoom into my nose, I'm already getting a runny nose. That happens a lot when I eat spicy food.
Yeah, I didn't die on the last one. I had the last one touch the back of my throat, my lip.
I don't even want to look at the milk.
What's your opinion of that sauce?
It tastes really sweet.
There's apricot in it. That's what.
Apricot? Yeah, but the moment, because I tasted it from the back of my tongue, it started to hit my throat in a bad way.
All right. So for your next question, what was the one TV show out of every TV show that you know, which one would you be in and why?
If it was still around, I would have loved to be on iCarly. Despite the whole Dan Schneider stuff, but iCarly is like literally one of my childhood shows. Actually, one of the inspirations on why I wanted to do videos in the first place.
Nice. If you had to axe off one other TV show in the real world just to bring it back, what would it be?
I would say Full House, but they already did a reboot. I would have to go with Victorious.
Okay,
it's already canceled. Wait, but does that count?
This is the Queen Majesty's Cocoa Ghost, aka Chocolate Ghost Pepper Sauce. It is common, by the way, that chocolate and chilies do go together, so this could actually be good.
It is, by the way. I'm not sure if you'll like it, though. I've had spicy chocolate before,
but not like this, though. Not like a sauce. I can see.
Well, now you're expanding your horizons.
Really? Yeah.
Wait, big caution sign.
I'm already on my way. I got like four. Wait, is this one of them?
No, that's the one I had from 2 years ago when I turned 16 in 2020. Cesar, I'm gonna warn you, after this sauce, this is where things get.
Oh, God!
This is where things.
This one's the big boy.
Cesar, this is where things are gonna get hot. It's just giving you a heads up.
Oh, my God. I'm not crying, I'm just tearing up from the freaking spice. Probably.
So we all.
Okay. Chocolate? Damn, it tastes good, but goodness, I can feel it.
So we know that you have a huge love for Nintendo. In fact, we recently saw your reaction to seeing the Super Mario Brothers movie.
Right.
Mm-hmm. If you had to pick one actor to play Mario, aside from Chris Pratt, who would it be?
Charles Martinet.
Nice.
I feel like he deserves the role. I mean, I gave out my opinion that maybe it's alright, that maybe Chris Pratt uses normal voice, but I just don't really like it as much because it doesn't sound accurate. Oh my God, talking burns my mouth. Hold on, let me inhale real quick. I just think Chris Pratt really needs to practice the Mario voice more.
This next one is the 13 Angry Scorpions, Jekyll and Hyde. This is a... what
this
I like to...
is the big one.
Brother lost.
This one made me tap
one.
Out. I was dying. You could have heard me scream.
So bad.
This one is what I would like to call a super spicier version of barbecue sauce.
Oh.
So if you like barbecue, then I think this should be okay. There you go. He just goes in.
He's hot. How much did he put in? Goodness.
You're sweating, dude.
Am I?
I think you're starting
not.
To sweat.
I'm not, it's like milk. I feel like I need it though. Can I take a sip?
You're this far, you can do it.
But this would you deserve it with this sauce. Just that way.
I'm not kidding.
Okay. Oh. So
you know what would be the biggest taunt in the finale? Wow. If you were to have me try the friggin' hottest one, and then when I reach for the milk, you pour it in the friggin' milk. All right,
okay, so it's a two-part question. What is your opinion of horror movies?
They're pretty good.
I'll make it a three-parter. What is your favorite kind of horror movie?
My favorite kind? God, dear God. My favorite kind of horror movie, I would have to say, is it'd have to be the remastered It, not the sequel, but the remastered It.
Oh, yeah. So you like the supernatural kind of horror movies? What is the worst horror movie possible? In fact, it's so bad that you could just spit it in the director's faces.
I like it. I like the movie, but I would say the worst one would have to be Cube.
Cube.
My brother, Isaac, he showed me Cube. It was pretty funny. It was like a low-budget one. It was kind of... Oh, my God.
It was fan artist film.
It was kind of cringe at the same time, but I liked it, though. It was funny.
Okay. Cesar, I'm going to give you the one. Now, this is the portion of it where it becomes serious. This next one is usually the one, as you know, is the one that causes the most trouble.
The bomb.
And luckily, this is not beyond insanity, but this is Evolution, which is said to be a better version of the
this
bomb.
This one tastes better, but is less hot.
No, it is not, people. Not in my opinion.
Don't lie to me!
Everyone had their own mixed
opinions. Lying. This is the hottest one here.
Wait, which is which? Like, they're all mixed together.
It's,
okay.
It's this one now.
This one, okay, okay.
They're right next. They're right in front of the one
in
their bottles.
Oh, my God.
Like 13
okay.
Is
this one of them?
No, that's awesome. From last year.
Okay,
2 years ago, so.
Okay.
That one's not good anymore.
Here it comes, and it hits immediately. Oh.
Kidding.
But is it hot though?
I can feel it in the back of my throat.
it's gonna start. The thing is about the bombs that it just does not go away.
I'm only taking sips of milk because I don't want to like make it a whole on rage quit.
The thing is, you also feel your blood pulsing at your ears.
Yeah.
Another problem
Oh god, I can feel it hitting the back of my throat.
This one doesn't go away.
Huh?
So with this one, you feel this one?
Okay, you got it?
Yeah, I got a runny nose already.
For a long time.
Okay.
But the question is
worse. But
What is one of the biggest and saddest ways you've had to cancel filming a video?
Oh god, canceling?
Yeah.
I've had to cancel a couple, actually. So you guys might remember Roller Coaster Love? That
yes.
was gonna be like one of the, it was gonna be like an LGBT special. Things led to things. I'm not really allowed to say what happened because it's like their own personal thing. But it did get canceled. I was kind of disappointed though because it was like a really good episode concept. I don't even know if this is canceled or not. More than likely it is. Sky the Puppet Remastered. It was a video that Isaac did on the Bossman Isaac 411 at one point. But oh my god, I hate this already.
You're not feeling how I feel.
Like, I was gonna remaster it, but he didn't really seem too interested, even though I tried paying him, and his voice is too deep, so that's probably another reason.
Okay.
And I tried imitating it, but it was bad.
Alrighty.
A question?
What?
If he kind of got hot up against one woman. One woman? Yeah. Wanna Rousey.
Ronda Rousey,
yep.
The wrestler.
Yeah.
Oh
my god.
Okay. Are you ready to move on, Cesar? You think you can move on?
I'm up for it.
This one is Peckerbutt.
Peckerbutt?
Puckerbutt.
Oh, Puckerbutt.
Puckerbutt. It's one of these sauces where it does not tell you what's in it.
Oh my god.
The good news is, from my experience, it's not as bad as was the one you just ate. But it is still not forgiving.
The fact that it's called Pucker Butt got me kind of nervous.
No.
This is gonna—I feel like this might kick me in the butt, but I'm not gonna give up.
Okay, good man. Hot.
Yeah. Oh, it's like green chili. I hate this. It's a. Am I crying? Do you see a tear?
Yes, I'm crying.
Oh my god!
He's crying, dude.
Oh my god, I can already feel a tear shedding out.
Yeah.
Is it that
He's at
powerful?
Number 9.
You made it past the ball?
Yeah!
Awesome job.
You know what? I feel really confident really for the finale. I'm scared, but I'm confident.
Okay.
But I love green chili. So, you got that green chili taste.
Okay, let me tell you something. Okay, before I give you this, because I'm just going to give you a heads up about the last one compared to the others.
What?
The one you just had was only 700,000 on the Scoville scale. This last one you're going to eat after this question I'm going to give you is 2.5 million.
Scovilles.
Goodness.
And
what's a question?
Okay. Who's better at cooking, your mother, your father, or your grandmother?
Oh my god, that's tough. I would have to probably... Oh, excuse me. Burped. I'd probably have to say my dad. My dad's really good at barbecuing.
Imagine your mother sees this and she's gonna be like, "Why did you abandon me, Cesar?"
I feel like she's gonna feel like she might try to go up for the challenge if that were the case.
Okay.
But yeah, my dad makes some bomb food. Enchiladas, chilaquiles.
He's using milk.
Steak? Okay. Oh my god, barbecue steak's so good.
Yeah, he's drinking.
Are you ready, Cesar, for the final wing?
No, but I'm gonna do it.
Okay. This one, ladies and gentlemen, is the legendary Last Dab Apollo. 2.5 million on the Scoville scale. It is literally just Tabasco equipped with one of the three hottest peppers in the world. There's the Carolina Reaper, the Pepper X, and the Apollo, hence the name.
Is it possible if I could get a refill on the milk? I might feel like I might need it after.
You might.
I haven't been.
There's another milk right here, by the way.
A little handicap?
There's another milk right there in case you need it.
Okay. I'm gonna handicap this. I went this far. I feel like I deserve it.
Okay. You might need it, actually, because of the. It might protect your throat.
Oh, look at the time. I gotta go. Okay, I'll stay.
Are you ready? And on 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. CJ Studios takes the bite of the last dab. Let's see what happens.
Oh god. That one's pretty bad.
That combined with iron with a little bit of the bomb and some angry
This stuff. Is the
Dear
most
God.
Unforgiving one.
Oh! That's powerful.
And
What's
you
that?
Can see Cesar has is tasting
did I taste
three
that
long
no,
lasting
he did not.
Hot
is that part of the challenge?
The
no, that was
time.
From last year's. That was 2 years ago from the challenge. People, turns out 2 years ago in 2020, on my 16th birthday, I've done this challenge before. I didn't make it past eight. Jesus, by the way, Cesar, who's suffering like a man. And my mother, who's over there, was the champion of both today and the previous one.
You survived this?
This man's a champion too.
You too?
Yeah.
Dear God!
We all did today, but 2 years ago, not a chance. The regular da bomb beyond insanity.
That's the one you survived with?
No, that's the one.
I'm saying where you
this
saying.
Is from the last year's jump. This was the previous last dab. The triple X. This one is hotter than this one. That's 2.5. 3.78 million.
Bomb.
In fact, for all of you out there, I'm taking one for the team.
Oh, shit.
If it's still good.
He liked it.
Oh.
Oh, God.
Me.
You idiot.
I'm only human, people. I have one last question for you. And as I do it with you, on this last one, I have to ask you, Cesar. And it has to do with the sauces. I'm going to point to one, and you just make a face of how you felt about it when you saw it. The one you just had, the last dab.
Are we at my facial reaction?
Yes. How about this one you actually but felt kind of scared by?
The chocolate one?
Yes, the chocolate one.
It tasted good. I actually liked it. That kick, though, oh my God, was terrible.
What was your facial reaction of it, though?
Oh my God, probably like, ugh.
What about this one? The last...
I'm gonna grab some water.
The bomb was angry. Spicy, but I actually liked the bomb.
Hmm. Okay, how about the one Justice suggested you? The 13 angry scorpions.
How about the biggest one? The big one. Caution.
Oh, God.
The hottest one. The number 7.
It had like a... It tasted kind of sweet, actually.
Mm-hmm. I said it was tasting like barbecue. And how about...
sweet honey barbecue, yeah.
How about the cantaloupe one?
The cantaloupe one. It was spicy. It was like spicy candy. It was pretty good.
Yeah. And last but not least, how about the first one you've had? The classic.
That shit tastes like nothing.
Junior, aka CJ Studios, made it through the gauntlet, and now we have nothing left but to roll out the red carpet for you, my friend. This camera.
Honestly, I passed it. I mean, I know it took 6 to film.
Let the people know what you have going on in your life.
Shout out to Sean Evans for creating the hot sauce.
Thank you, Sean Evans. So, wait, what was your question?
Let the people know what's going on in your life.
I'm doing pretty good. I have a job outside CJ Studios, obviously, but it tastes really good. Oh my God, I can feel my tongue
burning. And look at that.
Broke 1,000 subscribers on CJ Studios, and as we're filming this today, not when the video was uploaded, but as we're filming this today, it's CJ Studios' 2nd anniversary.
And, of course, my birthday party.
And
so,
birthday
two
party.
Great celebrations.
Happy birthday, John.
Thank you. Happy anniversary, Woo! Cesar.
Thank you.
And, cut.
You coughed!
Yeah.
Oh, it's not over yet.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jon-Luc. Happy birthday to you.
Anymore.
On Channel 4.
1984.
I just blew it out white before you even really hit the table.
I didn't even catch you blowing it. I mean, this was practice, so hey, if I ever do get a hot one, just if CJ Steel gets big, I'll try my hardest not to get the milk. Honestly, don't even give me milk.
I do it. Not screw around when it comes to spicy food, people. You know, it's an adventure for everybody. People, like, comment, subscribe, tap the bell if you want to never miss a show. Until next time, my brothers and sisters.
All right.
Stay spicy. And always... smile.